The Secret Agent by Joseph Conrad and Psychology. This novel is very noteworthy and worthwhile reading today in a world where we have psychopaths and conspirators running trucks over 84 people in Nice, from another Zangle. We have other lunatics shooting down policemen in Dallas, Baton Rouge, and probably other places. Not to mention the Paris attacks and other such terrible incidents. So the Secret Agent provides an insight into the mind of some of those lunatics who have been around for forever, one might say. There is some humor in all this darkness, because as mentioned previously, we have to cope with adversity and trauma, and one way to do that is to stop ruminating and boil in this juice which will get us down and all those around us, and find a way out. Think about something else, a joke maybe. So these conspirators and anarchists are plotting to blow a bomb, to ignite a bomb, what else? And they think about possible targets. So they mention an art gallery. An art gallery, says the other one. Who will care about that? Only the artists. Then they mention the Greenwich Astronomical Observatory. And again, the interlocutor is upset and says, but who will get killed there? Like today, they want to have as much impact as possible and as many human casualties as is feasible. That's their achievement, of course. And they also end up with who has something to complain about the observatory, meaning that they want to have targets, which soft targets as they call them today, which will somehow concentrate some of the animosity of the ordinary people. There is another aspect which sends one thinking about psychology. The fact that some, by all means not all, of the conspirators are what we call smart, intelligent. But this is exactly the point I'm trying to make. Intelligent in the sense that they, in the old traditional sense, they are capable to make calculations, plans, but they lack something which psychology today has demonstrated is much more important: emotional intelligence. Daniel Goleman is the one who has books on that, even if there will be some who trace the concept back before him. So these psychopaths have no social skills. When they socialize, it is just to plot with some of their fellows. And the definition of a psychopath is one who has no emotions, no feelings. And Tal Ben-Shahar, professor of positive psychology of Harvard, keeps saying, referring to negative emotions, which are also something which human beings encounter. It is all right to feel sad and depressed at times. Those who feel nothing are either the dead or a psychopath. So you should be glad that you're neither of these two categories, neither dead nor psychopath.